On Monday, Interior Secretary Ken Salazar announced plans to seek a policy that would ban uranium mining on land near the Grand Canyon for 20 years. Arizona Congressman Paul Gosar appeared on Horizon and expressed disappointment in Salazar's decision.
You know, we went up and toured one of these sites. It's actually a very clean mining aspect, and you're taking something out and you're replacing it with something that's pretty inert. And so I think from the standpoint is we've studied this, it's a smaller scale at about 20 to 30 acres, and they're very collapsed in form. And so I think there's a golden opportunity to have some very good mining propositions,
so
and not on scare tactics.
You think there's enough study?
I think there has, and I think you're always mindful of where you're going. When you're importing over 95% of all your uranium into this country for energy, it's an energy issue.
Here to share her views on uranium mining near the Grand Canyon is Sandy Bahr, director of the Grand Canyon chapter of the Sierra Club. Sandy, welcome.
Nice to be here.
I presume you disagree with what Congressman Gosar had to say. Why?
Absolutely. Well, we have worked for many, many years to protect the Grand Canyon and the lands around the Grand Canyon. We think that Secretary Salazar is right. There is only one Grand Canyon, and we ought to do everything we can to protect it and the Colorado River, which provides drinking water for all of us, to protect the groundwater, the seeps and springs in the Grand Canyon that help to provide habitat for wildlife. And frankly, he's wrong about the impacts. There's a legacy from uranium mining in the lands up around Grand Canyon, especially on the Navajo lands. There are still 520 mine sites that haven't been cleaned up. Some people might argue, hey, clean up the mess first before you even look at additional mines.
And what about his perspective on the energy issue aspect of things? Obviously, people are looking for ways to produce energy more cheaply.
Well, we don't think the future of the United States or of Arizona is in nuclear power. That is an energy generation that has problems on both ends. And the uranium mining, the contamination, the threats to groundwater and surface water, and then on the generation end, there's the whole waste issue, which we have never figured out how to deal with effectively.
Are there other protections in place? Congressman Gosar refers to the fact that he doesn't think it's quite as bad as you may be making it out to be. Are there protections in place that could, in fact, protect the land if there was uranium mining there, or is it too big of a risk to take?
We think it's too big of a risk. If there is contamination, we don't have any way to clean it up. When the Department of Environmental Quality came to Flagstaff and to Fredonia and held public hearings on some permits for these mines, they basically agreed with us. They said, you're right. And the other problem is, you know, we can't trust these agencies to be stringent enough. Department of Environmental Quality issued general permits, not individual, more protective permits for the mines that are being proposed up there. So, yeah, it's just too important to take the risk.
What are some of the risks from contamination?
Well, obviously, the water is a huge issue, and the risk to contamination of the groundwater, and eventually, a lot of it is connected to the seeps and springs in the canyon. And the hydrologists tell us that that is a high risk, and there's the whole radiation issue, plus uranium's a heavy metal. So it's a doubly toxic in a lot of ways. Horn Creek in the Grand Canyon is still contaminated from an old uranium mine, and the Park Service is working to clean that up right now. But they tell people, don't drink the water, don't bathe in the water.
Considering what an icon the Grand Canyon is, are you surprised it took this long to get these sort of protections?
Well, on one level, yes, but on another, no. It's always difficult to protect land, and luckily, Teddy Roosevelt had the foresight to establish Grand Canyon as a national monument using his executive power when the Congress wouldn't act, mm-hmm. Now we have the executive branch doing the same thing here.
Another mining issue is getting a lot of attention in Congress right now. It has to do with a huge copper deposit near Superior, Arizona, that's beneath land owned by the federal government. The Resolution Copper Company wants to mine that land, and it's proposing a land trade to do so. Congressman Paul Gosar introduced a bill to facilitate the trade. One of the sticking points is an environmental impact analysis that must occur before commercial mining can proceed. The Sierra Club says that review should take place before the land swap. Gosar's bill does it after the land deal is done.
if I'm a businessman, you know, I should have to detail that NEPA. You know, is the federal government and the taxpayer going to pay for the NEPA? There's no excuses for allowing businesses not to pick that claim up. And that's what's going to happen. They don't get to sidestep any of the ecological aspects from the Army Corps of Engineers to the Interior to water. But what ends up happening is instead of the taxpayer paying, the industry is going to pick it up. So I think we're very fiscally responsible when we do this bill this way.
Sandy, why does it matter when the environmental analysis takes place, as long as it takes place before commercial mining proceeds?
Well, first of all, you can call it the National Environmental Policy Act process, but that doesn't make it so. The whole idea behind that law is for the government to look before it leaps. These are public lands, the thing that Representative Gosar seems to forget. These are public lands. They're lands that President Eisenhower protected from mining over 55 years ago now. And this is not a minor issue. We should have a full analysis. We should have a mining plan of operation. We should know what they're going to do, how they're going to mine, where they're going to store the tailings, how they're going to process this ore. There are huge issues that none of which has been answered, and yet they want to go ahead with the land exchange. If in the National Environmental Policy Act process you find that there are devastating impacts, it's not like the land exchange is reversed. So what we've said repeatedly for the last 6 years is look at this ahead of time, make sure the taxpayers aren't getting ripped off, which they clearly are in this proposed land exchange. Resolution Copper stands to make virtually billions of dollars if there's the amount of copper they say there is. And the taxpayers get chump change. And of course they lose Oak Flat. That's just a bad deal.
Do you think the government has heard enough from the public on this and their concerns?
No. That's the other thing about the National Environmental Policy Act. They would have public meetings and outreach and opportunities for comment, but now everyone has to send their comments or testimony back to Congress, and you know, they have limited opportunity to comment here in Arizona unless they can catch Representative Gosar.
Sandy, finally, in this exchange, Arizona would get some land for conservation. Why is it not land that we should be excited about getting in the exchange?
Well, a lot of the parcels are relatively small, and even the parcel that has more ecological value on the San Pedro is threatened by nearby development, and that was one of the issues. There's a mine, BHP, that owns land nearby as well. We think that it's not a fair deal at all. It's not a good deal. But of course, there's been no in-depth analysis at all either, and it appears that Resolution Copper doesn't want that kind of in-depth analysis because they find out that the lands aren't as valuable as they say, and that the taxpayers are getting ripped off, and that the environmental impacts are significant, not to mention they're ignoring the concerns of the tribes, and in fact, I think insulting the tribes in a lot of ways.
Sandy Bahr of the Sierra Club, thanks for joining us on Horizon.